the privilege for us to share in the sacrament of baptism, as I said before, one of the two sacraments of our Presbyterian Church. And I would like to invite the Shaw family to come forward, and along with those who are going to be involved in supporting her, all are welcome. I'd also like to invite all the children that are here to come forward, and the kids can sort of sit right up here in front. Harrison Jack is being held by his mother, Megan, and to her left is her husband, Joshua, and they have three other children, Daphne, raise your hand, and Lincoln, raise your hand, and Penelope. Penelope had such a good time in my office the other day. That's it, that's what sisters are for. And Elizabeth Bauer is here as one of the sponsors, or sometimes called godparents in some traditions. Elizabeth lives in the great state of Minnesota where God lives. And also, in addition to Liz Nickerson, associate pastor, moving this direction, Nan Gregory, who is representing the Board of Deacons, and coincidentally was a teacher of Megan's at Dryden School, and Suzanne Mulligan, who is representing our session or our council. And Suzanne has known the Matta family for quite a while as well. And in fact, I was thinking and talking to you, Megan, what sort of a bittersweet day this is for me. It's the last baptism that I will probably publicly do here, at least in this context. But here's what's really interesting, that in August of 1981, when Susie and I moved to Arlington Heights, we moved on Mayfair Road, and the family that lived across from us was Jim and Marcy Matta. And at that time, they had two sons, one of whom is here today. And I vividly remember your mom and dad asked that if and when it came time for me to be born, if I could, or Susie could come over and be at the house so they could go to the hospital. And Jim, her father, calls at 3 in the morning, and he says, "Steve, are you busy?" Like, "Yeah, Jim, I'm not mowing the lawn." So I went over, and a few days later, you came home. And a few months later, I had the privilege of baptizing Megan. So today I have the privilege of baptizing their beautiful son, Harrison. So baptism is an act of the people of God, but it is grounded in Scripture. And Liz, would you like to share with us one reason why we baptize?
In the Gospel of Matthew, Jesus says, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. So go therefore and baptize in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teach them all that I have taught you. And lo, I am with you always to the end of the age."
Thank you. I often use the metaphor that baptism is like a three-legged stool. Harrison has the privilege of sitting on it or standing on it, which he'll be doing soon. But the three legs of the stool are God, of course, who will love Harrison unconditionally his whole life. Secondly, it's the two of you as parents and the extended family and friends. And then third, there's us, the church. And so baptism in our Reformed Presbyterian tradition is never anything that's done privately. It's always something that is done publicly, and it's always an act of the people of God. In presenting Harrison to be baptized, I would ask you these questions. As Kathy Godona so eloquently put in her prayer, do you recognize that there is evil in our world and those things that can threaten us to the values of God? But in your life and in the lives of your family, will you do everything possible to choose that which is good and that which is loving and that which is centered in God. Who? And who is your Lord and your Savior? And do you place your trust in Him as you choose to be parents and also place His love into their lives? Do you? And will you be a faithful member of the church? I'm assuming this church, they live in Cary, it's a little bit of a drive down here. But will you be a part of the faith community as to the best of your ability? Will you? Now this baptism is an act of the community. And to that end, Suzanne is here on behalf of our session or council, and she has a question to you as well.
Will we, the members and friends of Southland Street Church, provide an environment of nurture, care, and hope, in which Harrison and his family experience the presence of God and grow in Christ? If so, please respond, we will.
We will.
So I'd like to invite the children to come around. Now again, one of the beautiful things is that we are all a family in Christ. We are all members. So even though you guys are not directly brothers and sisters for Harrison, you are brothers and sisters in Christ. And so every time we baptize a baby, that's a new brother or sister that you have. And so maybe as you get older in Vacation Bible School, you would be a counselor to them. Maybe you would assist in Sunday school. Maybe you would babysit. You have not only just your immediate family, but you have this larger family of faith. So today it's really special for all of you to welcome Harrison and his brother Lincoln and his other sisters. So we are going to pray over the water. And would you like to come and help? We're going to pour that in a second, but first we're going to pray. Let's pray. Loving God, when John the Baptist baptized Jesus, the heavens broke open and your Holy Spirit descended like a dove. We ask you to send that same Holy Spirit to be present with us now. Transform this water from an ordinary to a holy. Send your Spirit to infuse this space. Send your Spirit to bless this water and then to bless Harrison. We give you thanks that you call all people to yourself, that you have called us here to remember our baptisms and to baptize in your holy name. Amen.
Y'all may be seated, children here, and any other children that want to are maybe dismissed for your children's time. And Megan and I are going to walk down here with Harrison's dad.